two, perhaps you could hear the aggressive, angry storm and the lighter, happier major sunshine. The contrasts are quite distinct in that piece. He was born in 1862 and died in 1908, born and died in New Jersey. Those in his hometown are convinced that the Stars and Stripes Forever is so good of a march that it must have actually been written by me. Yeah, the crowd goes wild. Okay. next on our program is a piece called Let There Be Peace on Earth. You've probably heard the piece before. It's super famous. I'll admit, I had not heard it because I'm a child of the 80s and the 90s. It was written in 1955. It was originally written for and sung by the International Children's Choir, created by Esther Peakley and Arthur Granger for the Granger Dance Academy in Long Beach. It has since been performed by groups in almost every single country in the entire world. It's in religious hymn books, it's in folk song song books, it's all over the place. See if you recognize it. You probably do. You can sing along.
Thank you.
Scottish corn century, To the Land of Enchantment, by Carol Britton Chambers. This was written last year, 2022, very modern, or current. It's broken into four movements, but they're not separate movements, they're just different sections of the piece. The first one is, let's back up. Land of Enchantment pays tribute to one of the composer's favorite places, New Mexico. The state's nickname is, in fact, the Land of Enchantment. This piece, first movement is called Breath. Breath begins with several sound effects, wind, rain, birds, all of these beautiful sounds one can hear when sitting beside the mountain streams or the lakes or when hiking through the desert or high country. With a quiet mind comes acute discernment and realization of how many diverse sounds actually exist in nature. The first breath, whether it's of the day, of someone's life, a new adventure, is powerful. The second movement is Landscape. It depicts the endless expanse of rolling hills, flat mesas, the jagged arrows seen when traveling across the state. The slurred, syncopated pattern in the woodwinds imparts a certain lilt to the journey. Movement three, Starry Night, begins with a woodwind choir accompanied by tinkling bells. That's a
very professional term.
Tinkling bells, because if a bell doesn't tinkle, what does it do? Okay, that was bad. And wind chimes all meant to remind us of the star-filled sky. I've never seen so many stars as when I was in New Mexico. The last movement, Heartbeat, is just that. A steady pulse that grows stronger and stronger, building up to an intense drumming, lightning strikes, thunderclaps. This section of the piece not only pays tribute to the state's long history and tapestry of cultures, such as the Pueblo Native Americans, it reminds us of the power of nature. Nature should never be taken for granted, and it deserves our utmost respect. Chairs settle so everyone can enjoy the Land of Enchantment. While I do that, after this piece, I'll introduce our assistant director. We'll do one more piece during intermission. There is a treasure chest out in the lobby where you're welcome to donate all your nature treasures to us. We are funded through the city, through membership dues by the band and by donations to the money donated goes directly to us. We buy music. New music costs like $80 a song to buy. It does have an expense and the facilities and whatnot. So if you're able to drop a $20 bill or Benjamin Franklin or something, some tan bars, whatever, into the box, we'd be very happy to take it. All right, Land of Enchantment. Thank you.
by Toto called Africa. It's not really about Africa, but it is, as they say, a headbanger.
Thank you.
this particular next song, down in the river, down in the river. It's one of those revival tunes that you'll hear most famously done in a movie that you might know by the Coen brothers called Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Here you'll hear it in an ABA setting. That is to say, you'll feel free to sing along if you recognize the tune. It'll be an exposition where you can hear the song. There's a development section where the song kind of goes away, and if you don't know the song or you suddenly find yourself not being able to sing along, just wait, because you'll get your chance again in the recapitulation where you'll be able to hear the song in all its glory once more. Anytime you feel like singing, no problem. Folks, this is Down in the River.
Thank you.
Milpitas Community Band in the city of Milpitas. Rebecca, our supervisor. Well, wherever you are, thank you very much. It is always an honor and a privilege to be able to work with this ensemble. The next song is a song about being over the rainbow.
Continue on the nostalgic journey here with music from The Lion King. Some argue it's one of Disney's greatest hits. This has almost every song you can remember from it. If you want to join in, feel free. Enjoy The Lion King. The original.
Thank you.
know what a Tutued toucan looks like, there it is. Okay. So it's exactly like you would imagine. Okay. This is a great little tongue-in-cheek spin-off of the famous Orpheus in the Underworld's can-can by Jacques Offenbach. You will hear, it sounds an awful lot like that, but it's not quite. You'll also hear a couple of other classical pieces sneak its way in. See if you can identify all of the hidden pieces in this work. It's just enough different that it's like, might sound like a wrong note or a wrong rhythm, but it's on purpose. It's just enough to like, just when you think you know where it's going, haha, just kidding. So please enjoy the Toucan. You're cheating, you can see the fruit. Okay. Thank you.